I'll begin this lesson by opening Excel. As I'm on the Windows 8 desktop, I'll click the Start button, and then I'll click the Excel 2013 tile that we added earlier. I'll then choose the blank workbook template, and I'm presented with a new blank workbook. If you're coming to Excel 2013 from an earlier version of Excel, you'll immediately notice that the Excel screen now has very little use of colour and contrast. A very large number of Excel users, myself included, feel that this lack of contrast causes more eye strain and is more difficult to work with than earlier Excel versions. Fortunately, you're able to change Excel's default white colour scheme to one with higher contrast using the new Office Themes feature. Three Office themes are available to customise the look and feel of Excel. Let's explore them now by changing the Office theme. So click the File button at the top left of your screen, and then Options towards the bottom of the left-hand menu bar. And in the Personalise Your Copy of Microsoft Office section, you can see that there's an Office theme drop-down. I'm going to click the button to the right of that drop-down to see that there are three themes available: white, light grey, and dark grey. Let's look at light grey first of all. So I point to and click on light grey, and then click the OK button. You can see that the light grey theme has a little more contrast that helps to separate screen elements. Now let's look at the dark grey theme. To do that, once again I click on the File tab, then Options, and then in the Personalise Your Copy of Microsoft Office section, the Office theme will become dark grey. I click OK, and you can see that there's a much higher contrast in the dark grey theme. This is my own personal preference. I find the higher contrast is a lot easier to work with. Experiment with each theme until you discover the one that you prefer. All of the screen grabs in my book, and all of the screen grabs in this video course, were done using the dark grey theme. If you choose a different theme, the screen grabs in the book will look slightly different to what you're seeing on your computer screen. You may have also noticed that, in my copy of Excel, there's a clouds tattoo at the top right of the screen. This is called a background. Now, you can only customise your background if you're connected to the internet and logged in using a Microsoft account. You're going to learn a lot more about Microsoft accounts later in Session 8, when we'll discuss cloud computing. Personally, I find the background feature is a little frivolous for a serious business application, and for this reason, I always leave it set to no background. But perhaps you feel differently and would like to stamp your own identity onto your copy of Office. So let's now change the background. I'll click the File tab, as I did before, and the Options button from the left-hand menu bar. I can see that on my copy of Excel, there's an Office background drop-down. But you won't see that on your copy of Excel unless you're signed in using a Microsoft account and are connected to the internet. I'll click the drop-down button now to see which background options exist. And you can see there's quite a lot of them. But in my case, I'm going to select No Background and click the OK button. And you can see that the top right of the screen is now free of the tattoo. Let's now close down Excel by clicking the Close button at the top right of the screen. And you've now completed Lesson 1-3, Change the Office Theme.